Greetings, Your Excellencies, in the beautiful, matchless name of our Lord Jesus Christ and Savior. I hope that you really enjoyed that worship and found yourself singing along and worshiping and entering into the flow. Such a beautiful, beautiful, awesome worship that we have available to us any time of the day or night. Welcome to the 21st session of the GBR International Intercession Session of the Global Business Roundtable. We are in a season of prayer and fasting as a organization because we're preparing to go into our 11th prayer camp. Because we are not able to meet together due to the current pandemic, we are now going to host prayer camp via Zoom. So we'll be having a virtual prayer camp. And we're very excited about it. We've met together, we've prayed, we've sought the Lord, and we have a fantastic, let's say the Lord gave us an incredible program for the upcoming dates, which are, if you'll diarize them, they're the 19th to the 24th of February. We'll be meeting on Zoom at 5 o'clock. Well, we have personal prayer from 4 to 5, like we normally do. And then from 5 o'clock to 7 o'clock, we'll be live on Zoom together. So from 5 to 7, we'll be on Zoom, enjoying and sharing the word, but most of all praying and meeting with God. I'd like to just pray, if we can just pray. Father, we want to thank you for this day. We want to thank you for all the blessings that you've laid up for us, Father. We want to thank you, Lord, that you are the God who sees, that you are our blessed assurance. We want to thank you, Father, for the sound dimension and the dimension that you've given to every man and woman of worship and, Lord, of prayer. Father, that it is not a select few that are called to spend time with you, but it is all of your children all over the world. And Lord, we want to thank you for this portal and for this time. Lord, that we have an opportunity to share, to pray together as a corporate, and Father, to hear from heaven. And so, Holy Spirit, we invite you to come and speak to us, Lord. Father, I pray that this session will be a session of great prophetic activation for every person that is tuned in and for every single person who gets to listen to this, whether at a later stage, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. We have a shofar nugget. If we can just pull up the shofar slide, please. Today we are talking into Joshua and Jericho. And every week where I will be facilitating, which is not every week, I'll share a little nugget of the power and the purpose of the shofar. In Joshua 6, verse 5, 4 and 5, the word says, "And 7 priests shall bear 7 trumpets of ram's horns before the ark. But the seventh day you shall march around the city 7 times, and the priests shall blow their trumpets." That's a lot of sevens. Interesting to note. And then in 5b, it says, "And when you hear the sound of the trumpet, that all of the people shall shout with a great shout." That's the teruah. "Then the wall of the city will fall down flat." Now, when we blow our shofars today, we are going to trust God that whatever is standing in our way, whatever is holding our resources, whatever restrictions, whatever walls exist that are between you and what God is wanting you to possess, as we blow the shofar today, we're going to believe that that is going to supernaturally fall down in the realm of the spirit. Now, if you don't have a shofar, At GBR, we use our shofars because we understand the purpose and the power that God has given us in our armory as intercessors. We all have an armory. We all have an arsenal. And the shofar is one of those weapons that we need to exercise and use often because of what the impact it has in the realm of the spirit. So we also know that it's the sound of the blood because of the ram in the thicket. But I shared that another week. So excellencies, won't you join me? Take your shofar. Let us make a declaration in the realm of the spirit that every wall of opposition is coming down in the name of Jesus. You're welcome to unmute for the blowing of the shofar as we blow together. If you are, it's healing you need, if it's resources you need, whatever it is, whatever is standing between you and what God wants you to have today, we're going to blast that open in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Down. We decree and we declare the walls are down in Jesus' name. Whatever's been standing between you and that which has been giving you uphill and which has been opposing you in Jesus' name, as we've blown our shofars, we know in accordance with the word, and that is sure that the walls are coming down in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Excellencies, today we have a great topic called Activating the Faith of Every Believer. Now, what is faith? Faith is our substance. What is the substance? Substance of the things unseen. Hallelujah. And we're going to hear today and we're going to pray through this. So if you've got any blockages in your in the activation of your faith, I don't know what it might be. It might be for speaking in tongues. It might be for walking in divine healing or the gifts of healing. It might be in trusting God just for daily bread. Today, we are going to trust the Lord for that activation that releases our faith. We have our dearest friend, Pastor Irene. She is our exhorter for today. You'll see our format every week. We have an exhorter. Then we have a prayer champion, number one, prayer champion, number two. And we open and close with the blowing of the shofar. And we also close with the communion. And I just realized I don't have mine with me, but that's not a problem. So, excellencies, if you're here for the first time, I want to welcome you warmly. I want to say to you that you are very, very welcome. We appreciate you. We appreciate who you are in the kingdom. And we appreciate and love every single one that has come to this platform today. And I pray that you will feel that love, that you will feel that acceptance, that you will know as an intercessor that you're coming to a pool which is well stirred with the miracle working faith of Jesus Christ, and that you've come to a place for intercessors to land. So, Excellency Pastor Irene is going to be sharing on activating the faith of every believer and activating the faith of every believer. Our prayer champion, number one, is Excellency Linda Gnassol. I hope I say that right, from Côte d'Ivoire. We have a little glitch today. One of the ladies who members who normally interprets for us, is Grace from Senegal, but she had two situations where not just one of her close friends passed, but two. So we've released her, but unfortunately we don't have an interpreter today. But we know that the Lord is going to give us the grace to be able to move through that. I thank you, Excellency Linda, because I know that you did your presentation in English and French, and that was a foresight, and we really thank you for that. And then our prayer champion number two is Apostle Bubs, whom we know and we love, from Nigeria. And he will come in a little bit later because he also has a meeting running, as do many of our stalwarts, Apostle Joseph and Excellency Oyabunji. So you will see they will pop up a little bit later. But to us that are here, we've not come to a mountain built with hands. We have come to Mount Zion, the city of our God. Hallelujah. Amen. Is there an amen out there? Or am I preaching to myself here?
Amen.
Amen. Thank
amen.
You. Thank amen. You.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, I can hear the glory people have arrived. We want to thank you for making your appointment sure. Pastor Irene, I'd like to hand over to you now, Excellency. Pastor Irene is a powerhouse. We know that she loves God, and we know that she carries the gold. She carries the glory. Hallelujah. So we welcome you, we thank you. Amen.
Amen. Now, this morning I want to greet all the excellencies in the wonderful name of Jesus. I want to greet our convener and all the leadership of GBR, GFFJ, and Apostle Joseph Nyalungu, and Excellency Carol this morning, and the leadership of Intercession and the Fivefold this morning, and all the nations that are on this hour of intercession. I greet you in the mighty name of Jesus. This morning we have a very exciting topic that we talk about. In this time of despair, in this time where the waves are way above us, we can speak about faith this morning. We can speak about faith. I just want to read the scripture in Isaiah 43. The word of God says, from verse 1, we'll pick up a little bit into the chapter. 43 verse 1 says, but now, thus says the Lord, who created you, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel. He says to us, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you. Then he goes further in verse 3. He says, for I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I gave Egypt for your ransom, Ethiopia and Seba in your place. Since you are precious in my sight, you have been honored and I have loved you. Therefore, I will give men for you and people for your life. Then he comes in verse 5. He says, fear not, for I am with you. I will bring your descendants from the east and gather you from the west. I will say to the north, give up, give them up, and the south, do not keep them back. Bring my sons from afar, my daughters from the ends of the earth, everyone who is called by my name, whom I have created for my glory. I have formed him, yes, I have made him. Hallelujah. This is a promise, a redemption promise from the Lord. Now, when we speak of Israel, we speak about the church. And when we speak about the church, we speak about us. We speak about ourselves this day. We are the church. Now, when we say we are activating faith, my question was, when I looked at the subject, I questioned myself and I said, Lord, I said, Irene, you are one of the people that loves to quote the scripture on faith. Even if I pray, anything that I do, I love to quote the scriptures on faith. And recently, the question of the verse, the scripture that says, when Jesus asked, when I come back, shall I find this measure of faith? Recently, that scripture dawned to me. I started meditating on the scripture, because if he asks us, if he says to us, would I find a measure of faith? Then it means to say he has given us a measure of faith. And then when I look at the scripture, he says, if your faith is as small as a mustard seed, you will be able to move mountains. So then it means to say, Jesus, the Father, as he has built us, has given us a measure of faith unseen, faith that we don't realize as children of God, as believers, that we have. And then again, I looked at it and I said to myself, I went to Hebrews 11. And Hebrews 11 from verse 1. And now today, I just sense we're going to read a lot of scripture, because the word is the light. When Apostle Joseph spoke on the word last week, he spoke of light. The word brings light. The word brings, I believe the word brings conception. The word brings birthing. The word brings victory. The word makes us to overcome where we find ourselves in a place where we are in this dispensation. Now, Hebrews 11 from verse 1 says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtained a good report. Through faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which appear. Now, there's a strong spirit dimension of faith. Sadly, as I said earlier, that believers are unable to comprehend. We are unable, we live in faith, but we are unable to conceive. We are unable to comprehend that the faith that we have, the faith that God has given us, I would say that faith is a currency of exchange for spiritual transactions with God. What is faith? Faith assures us, guarantees us, convinces us, promises us things that are unexpected. It convinces us the existence of things that we cannot see. And faith means knowing something that is real, even if we do not see it. That is faith. Faith is knowing that something is real, although you don't see it. Faith is knowing that God has now. Faith is knowing that God, that you have now what you have been praying for. When we pray, the faith that we have, we believe that God has answered our prayers. When I look at Daniel's life, when he went into that 21 days, he didn't even comprehend that the answer was given to him in the first day. The first day when he asked, he was given the answer. And the angel of Pearson stole his answer. But he didn't get despondent. He went against the odds, against the instruction of the king that said no one's supposed to pray. He went away at his lunchtime, and a certain place at his place, he looked through the window and he called upon the name of the Lord. And the angel came. And Michael said to him that he fought, he's fighting for his answer because his answer was given in the first day. Now, that is why I say faith is knowing that you have now, not tomorrow, today. Whatever you ask is the now. That is faith. That is having faith. Faith is when you go to the light switch and you switch, you put your finger to the switch. Faith is the light will come on, whether it is dark. And in your sorrow today, faith is that it is now as I speak. Whatever is the trial, whatever you ask the Father, faith is believing that this prophetic season, this prophetic session, that we are speaking of activating the faith of our believers. We are activating the faith that we believe what we asked the Father 2 minutes ago, what we asked the Father at 9 o'clock this morning, what you asked the Father at 3 o'clock this morning. It is now. It is now. Kinako. It is the time. It is time now that the faith that you have is in action, because he said, I have formed you. You are mine. And faith is believing even if we don't see. I just want to go a little bit back to our scripture in Hebrews 11. I just want us to just visit a little bit there. When we talk about the elders, hallelujah. When he speaks about Abram, he says, by faith, Abram obeyed when he was called out of the place which he would receive as inheritance. And when he went out, not knowing where he was going to, by faith, he dwelled in the land of promise as in a foreign country. He even had to dwell in tents with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs with him of the same promise. For he waited for the city which has foundations, whose builder and maker is God. He had to leave his country. Some of us sometimes lose his businesses. We lose a home, we lose family, and we land up in a strange land. But he says, wait, those that wait upon the Lord shall receive. They shall receive strength. They shall receive power. Hallelujah. We go to Sarah. Sarah herself also received strength to conceive seed and she bore a child when she was past her age, because she judged him faithful who had promised. Today, I want to encourage you. Judge God. Judge God today. Judge him faithful, because he is more than faithful. He says, I will do exceedingly abundantly above what we think, what we ask. Hallelujah. And what we pray for. Therefore, one man, the word of God says in verse 12, Hebrews 11, verse 12, he says, therefore, from one man and him as good as dead were born as many as the stars of the sky in a multitude, innumerable as the sand which is by the seashore. And this morning, we are encouraging you. We are saying, take up your cross and follow Jesus. When the disciples, when Mark and John and them and the brothers were fishing, Jesus passed and he said, leave what you are doing, follow me. They left what they were doing and they followed him. By faith, they followed him. And this morning, we want to say to you, faith is knowing. Again, I repeat myself. Faith is knowing that you have now what you have been praying for. Faith is agreeing with God. And God cannot lie. He is no man that can deceive us. He is able to give what you currently cannot see. Faith again is agreeing with God and not entering the if not. We don't enter what if. When we have asked him, he says it shall be established. God's promises and shouting out all doubts and unbeliefs of us as believers. God's promises is yea and amen. He promises that he will never leave us. He will never forsake us. He says he will never, never forsake you. He even says that he will never put you to shame. Whatever you go through, he will never let you be in shame. Sometimes we feel that it is a shame for people to know where we are. But God says he will take you out of it.
Amen.
He says, call unto me and I will show you great and mighty things. Hallelujah. I just want to talk a little bit of Noah, because he's one of the elders that had to build an ark. Noah didn't know anything about rain, but he had to build an ark because he was instructed to build an ark. And I was imagining my day, God coming here in Johannesburg and saying, Irene, build an ark, I'm coming. And the people like we are preaching the gospel today, they saved since the ages. They are saying Jesus is coming. Jesus is not coming. I was even reminded of the visitation that convener got from the Lord when he was in Israel, instructing him about the largest fund on earth. It is faith that made convener stand up when he was told to do the prayer, a prayer meeting in his home. It was faith. All odds was against him. But his faith brought us to here. And it is faith that is going to take us further. It is that faith that the elders had. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Moses, when he became of age, he refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter,
But you know, when I think of Jacobet, I call her Jacobet. Hallelujah. If Jacobet didn't have, hallelujah, she didn't have that faith to put a little baby in a cradle, hallelujah, there wouldn't be an intercessor for Israel.
Amen.
She saw that her son has to live.
Amen.
She put him on the waters, hallelujah. And she pushed him. It is a faith that made her push a baby with a teenage daughter. And she knew the maker and the perfecter, the author, and the perfecter of a faithful seed to a baby. Because if he brought him to earth, hallelujah.
Amen.
He has to finish what he has started, hallelujah. And Moses became a great leader, a great intercessor for the plan and purpose of what God had. Remember when Abraham took Isaac, God promised him Isaac. And next best thing, God says, offer him, sacrifice him. It was by faith. It was faith that Abraham knew that, you know what, even if I put him to death, God's promise will stand.
Amen.
And this day, whatever you are going through, whatever you are carrying, take heed this day. He says, I have formed you. I will never leave you. He says he will give people in your way. He says, if you obey him, hallelujah, we need to come to that place, even through the odds, even what we see, even what the government is deciding, even whoever is deciding. God says he will be there for us, hallelujah. He will keep us, hallelujah. He will let us stand, hallelujah. I just want to repeat as I finish off the last piece where he says in verse 7, he says, everyone who is called by my name, whom I have created for my glory, I have formed him. Yes, I have made him. Now he has formed us. He has made us. And you know, when we pray, even I thought I want to encourage us as excellencies, when we pray for those that cannot breathe, when we pray for those that are sick with this pandemic that has befallen our world, we speak the oracles of God and we remind the Father that he breathed his breath of life.
Amen. Amen.
In the nostrils of our people. You know, in last year, there was a time between June and July, August, that I couldn't breathe. I was so ill. And every time I couldn't breathe, I said, Lord, I breathe through your nostrils. Breathe your breath of life in my nostrils. Hallelujah. And this day, brethren, excellencies, take heed and keep the faith. Hallelujah. Amen and amen.
Amen, amen and amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you so much, Excellency Irene. Amen. Breathe the breath of the Father. Breathe through the nostrils of the Father. Thank you so much. You said a lot there. The word is the seed and brings forth life. And faith is such a vital thing, because without his word, what are we standing on? And I want to endorse that and say, whatever God has said to you in your life, believe him. Believe him. Believe him. Do not give up, but hold fast. Believe him, because faith is based on his word and what he has said to you. And that is why we have the Rhema word, because the Logos word, which is the written word, becomes the living word, which is the Rhema word. When God speaks a Rhema word to you and gives you a promise, that is what we hold on to, That is what we speak and that is what we live in. So I want to thank you, Excellency Amen. Pastor Irene, for that was a basket full of, you filled our basket because the God is faithful to
yes,
whoever he promises, he keeps his word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you so much.
Amen.
Excellencies, I'm going to hand over to our prayer champion, Excellency Linda Gnosso. She is French speaking. And as I said earlier, we were struggling for our interpretation. So we're going to flow in the spirit now. And over to you, Your Excellency. Welcome. We are blessed to have you with us. Linda is the head of intercession for Côte d'Ivoire. And she also is for Global Fund for Jesus. So we welcome you, Your Excellency.
Hi, Excellency. Thank you. Thank you, Excellency. I bless God for all nations and for the GBR, all people at this meeting. The topic of this prayer is activating the faith of believers. I bless God for this great message for Pastor Irene. And I will pray in French. My presentation is also in
French. Bless you, bless you, Excellency.
Okay.
Excellency. Sorry to interrupt you, Your Excellency.
Yes.
May I just ask everybody to mute, please? We're getting some feed. So if you don't mind, just to mute your mic, apart from Excellency Linda. Thank you so much. Thank you, Your Excellency. Go ahead.
Thank you, Excellency. Alors, I will pray. Comme je disais, je vais prier en français. Et nous avons retenu de la prédication de Pasteur Irene que la foi est donnée par Dieu. C'est une mesure de foi qui nous a été donnée par le Seigneur. Dans Romains 12, verset 3, il est dit que c'est une mesure de foi. Et en anglais, il est dit « But to think reasonably as God has apportioned to each person a measure of faith. » Dieu nous a donné une mesure de foi à chacun et donc chacun dispose de la foi. C'est pourquoi nous devons croire que même pour être sauvé, il fallait que la foi soit associée à la grâce. Et c'est comme ça que nous avons été sauvés. Et la foi également est un moyen. C'est au moyen de la foi que nous sommes sauvés. Alors, nous allons rendre grâce au Seigneur. Nous allons bénir Dieu parce que de cette prédication, j'ai retenu 3 points. I found 3 points in this message. Topic of prayer. The first topic of prayer is to pray that believers continue to listen and hear the word of God, which carries the voice and the will of God. Pray. Seigneur, nous te bénissons et nous te rendons grâce. Parce que c'est toi qui nous donnes la foi. Et tu as dit que la foi vient de ce qu'on entend et de ce qu'on entend la parole de Christ. Et nous savons que dans Romains 10, 17, la foi vient de la parole. Nous prions qu'en ces temps de crise, en ces temps de pandémie, que la parole de Dieu ne se retire point de tes enfants. Parce que tu as dit que la foi vient de la parole, que ces temps que nous traversons, ces temps d'adversité, que le peuple de Dieu parle la parole. Seigneur Saint-Esprit, nous croyons que tu es fidèle. Nous croyons que tu es puissant pour nous donner de rester connectés à la parole, de rester attachés à la parole. Nous devons rester connectés à la parole. Merci Seigneur. Allons sur la slide 2, slide 2. Merci Saint-Esprit, merci Seigneur. Alors, nous disons ici que nous devons rester attachés à la parole. Romains 10, verse 11 says, so faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. Nous allons prier. Pray that the people hear the words of God. Stay connected to the word of God. Seigneur, merci parce que tu nous donnes d'être connectés à ta parole. Tu nous donnes d'être attachés à ta parole. Quand les temps sont difficiles, tu as dit le juste, que ferait-il? Le juste doit s'attacher à la parole. Quand les temps sont mauvais, on doit s'accrocher à la parole. C'est pourquoi ce matin, nous prions que nous soyons tout le temps connectés. Comme il est dit dans 1 Roi 10, que le peuple de Salomon, la reine de Saba, a constaté que le peuple était constamment devant Salomon et était constamment en train d'écouter sa sagesse. Je prie ce matin que le peuple de Dieu reste connecté à la voix de l'Éternel, reste connecté à la parole de Dieu qui est la source de la foi. Oui, sans la foi, la Bible déclare, on ne peut pas lui être agréable, mais aussi, la foi vient de la parole, et la parole de Dieu est celle-là qui nous permet de tenir dans des temps d'adversité, au nom de Jésus. Merci Seigneur. Nous allons aller sur le deuxième point, slide 2. Au niveau de la foi, il est dit que la foi est bonifiée par la prière. Jésus a dit dans Luc 18, le verset 1, il dit, il faut toujours prier et ne point se relâcher. Oui, he also spoke a parable to them that they must always pray and not give up. Nous ne devons jamais abandonner. Nous ne devons jamais abandonner. Il dit au verset 32, Luc 22, le verset 32, I prayed for you that your faith wouldn't fail. Nous devons prier pour que notre foi ne défaille point. Dans Isaïe 40, verset 31, il dit, but those who wait for Yahweh will renew their strength. They will mount up with wing like eagles. They will run and not be weary. They will walk and not faint. C'est pour dire que la parole de Dieu est le moyen de la prière permet d'augmenter la foi. La prière permet de garder la foi. Alors nous allons prier que le Seigneur nous donne encore aujourd'hui à son Église, à son peuple, aux croyants, de croire ce que la parole de Dieu dit, de prier. Parce que c'est dans la prière que nous pouvons être forts dans la foi. Une foi qui ne prie pas ne peut pas être augmentée. Alors nous allons demander au Seigneur de nous donner la capacité de toujours prier. Tendre Père, nous voulons te dire merci. Tendre Père, nous voulons te rendre grâce. Donne-nous de toujours prier. Donne à ton peuple de toujours prier, de demeurer dans la prière. Parce que Seigneur, tu as dit qu'il faut toujours prier et ne point se relâcher, ne point se décourager. Ce n'est pas un esprit de timidité que tu nous as donné. Ce n'est pas un esprit de défaitisme que tu nous as donné. Ce n'est pas un esprit de découragement que tu nous as donné. Mais c'est un esprit de puissance, un esprit de force et de sagesse. Père, c'est au nom de Jésus que nous croyons que la prière bonifie notre foi. Remo sataradabre kerebo shadara. Seigneur, renouvelle les forces de ton peuple. Renouvelle la foi au nom de Jésus. Merci, Saint-Esprit de Dieu, pour ce que tu entreprends pour nous. Nous croyons que tu es le Dieu qui nous bonifie dans la foi, par la prière. Nous prions sans cesse. Nous ne nous relâchons point. Que ton peuple ne se relâche point. Seigneur, tu as dit que Jochebed a été cette femme-là qui s'est engagée, qui n'a pas laissé la loi de Pharaon l'atteindre. Mais au contraire, Moïse a été sauvé dans la maison de Pharaon parce qu'elle a eu la foi et cette foi l'a conduit à manifester ce qu'elle avait en elle. Père, ce matin, merci. Amen. Pour cette prière que tu renouvelles en nous. Merci pour Noé qui en son temps a écouté Dieu et a entendu la voix de Dieu et a été capable de manifester cette foi et de croire en la promesse de l'Éternel. Merci Seigneur pour ta fidélité. Merci Seigneur pour ta grâce. Père, nous croyons que tu es bon et fidèle pour conduire ton peuple. Oui, conduis le GBR dans le plan, dans le programme, dans le camp de prière qui est organisé du 17, du 19 au 24. Nous croyons que tu es à l'œuvre. Élève, Seigneur, la foi de tes enfants. Augmente la foi dans la prière. Que des hommes et des femmes de prière se lèvent, Seigneur. Que des hommes et des femmes de prière soient catapultés dans leur destinée. Papa, tu as dit que c'est par la prière que nous obtenons les promesses. Tu as dit que si vous demandez avec foi dans la prière, vous serez exaucés. C'est pourquoi nous croyons que par la prière, Seigneur mon Dieu, dans la foi, nous serons exaucés au nom de Jésus. Merci pour ta fidélité. Merci pour ta bonté. Merci parce que tu le fais, Père, au nom suffisant de Jésus. Nous proclamons ce matin que tu es le Dieu qui augmente la foi par la prière. Nous ne voulons pas abandonner parce que, Père, celui qui prie, celui qui se confie en toi, renouvelle ses forces, renouvelle ses capacités. Il prend de l'envol comme l'aigle. Quand il marche, il ne se fatigue point. Quand il court, il ne se lasse point. Mais il remporte des victoires au nom de Jésus. Start slide free. Dans la slide 3, il est dit, we must exercise our faith. We must put our faith in work. We see Abraham. In Romans 4, Abraham, not like the word says that who he hope, he believed again hope to the end that he might become. Faith might our become. La foi nous fait devenir. So will you see be without being witness in faith? He didn't consider his own body, the Bible says. He didn't waver through unbeliever, but grew strong through faith. Nous allons prier. Comme Abraham, il a espéré, il a cru Dieu, il believe to God, il croit God. On va demander encore au Seigneur que les chrétiens mettent leur foi en action. Abraham a démontré, il demonstrate his faith. Abraham a démontré qu'il avait la foi. Il n'a pas regardé son corps. Il said, he didn't look his body who was already warm, but he believed God. On va prier le Seigneur. Remo satara da breke rebo satara dandoro color baraka satara balara dandoro doro. De rebo satara da brakaria de kotoro color balara dandoro. Aya de rebo satara kalara balara dandoro kotoro color balara dandoro.
Père, ce matin encore, donne-nous de rester dans la foi, donne-nous d'écouter ta parole, donne-nous de démontrer ta la foi. Seigneur, tu as dit, Seigneur mon Dieu, que la foi est une ferme assurance des choses qu'on espère. Seigneur mon Dieu, pour le camp de prière, nous proclamons ce matin que tu vas susciter des prédicateurs. Tu as dit, comment entendons-tu parler? Comment entendons-tu si personne ne prêche? Tu as dit, Seigneur, Seigneur, envoie des prédicateurs, de la parole, afin que la foi soit suscitée, que la mesure de foi soit bonifiée. Tu as dit que la parole de Dieu est la semence de la foi. La parole de Dieu est une semence semée dans nos cœurs. Rimo satara da réprimons les plans de l'ennemi et nous proclamons ce matin que la puissance de la foi opère dans le cœur des croyants. La puissance de la foi. Intercesseurs se lèvent, intercession. Seigneur mon Dieu, des prières, Seigneur des adorateurs de l'Éternel, afin que la foi soit maximisée, que la foi soit mise en avant, au nom de Jésus. Que tout ce qui était découragement, Seigneur, découragement par rapport au coronavirus, découragement par rapport à la pandémie actuelle, nous proclamons que cela ne nous arrêtera pas. Parce que Père, tu as dit dans ta parole, au nom de Jésus,
Jesus. Yes, alara malaran dan 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 di I just want to share a vision. I see what I'm seeing is I'm seeing that there are people, excellencies, if we can just let's just come together. While we were praying, I was seeing, you know, when you truss up a chicken or when you have a ham, okay, they put these little things on the ends of the feet. They look like little white caps. Little white caps. So what I was seeing when we were praying, I was seeing that many of us have been capped. We've been capped. Okay? So what does that mean? Prophetically, what that means is there's been certain things have happened to you. They can be traumas. They can be accidents. They can just be an incident. There can be something that created this cap over your ability to function. And what's happened, and the hands, I see it on the hands and the feet and the head. And while we were praying, what I was beginning to see was that capping is what was stopping you. So whereas before this happened, you could flow beautifully. You could believe God. But there came these things that happened, even words, even actions against you that created an environment whereby you became covered. Your hands, your feet. So your walk, you couldn't walk like you normally walk. You couldn't do what you normally do, and you couldn't think what you normally do. And I saw why we were busy interceding together like that. Thank you, Excellency Linda, for leading us in that. I saw that those things were being pulled off. They were like paper, but once they were on the body or on the being, they stuck. But while we were praying, they were being pulled off. So they were being removed. Those oppressions were leaving our minds, leaving our hands, and leaving our feet. And there came mobility. There came freedom. So we decree and we declare in accordance with Father, what you did while we were in intercession now. Because of the way, Father, your faith and our faith, Lord, our faith together mixed, created a circumstance in the realm of the spirit whereby you released us and broke those things off our minds, off our hands, and off our feet, Lord, so that we can truly be free this day. And Father, everything that has hindered our faith in this last season, we thank you, Father, that you've removed
all the restrictions.
You've taken away everything that has encumbered us. You've removed all of that fear, Lord, all that paralysis. Father, all that muting is off today in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Father, for breakthrough for every single one on this chat in GBR and GFFJ in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Your Excellency.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Thank you, Father. Glory. Every single one, every person, every woman, every child, every family member.
Yes, Lord.
Every man. All released from that.
Glory to Jesus. Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Excellency Irene, I'd like to do something a little bit out of character, but I'm going to ask you to take us into the breaking of the bread. Can we do that? Excellency Irene?
Yes, Excellency Carol.
Can you take us into the bread? Into breaking of bread. I see you've got a feed on your mic, Excellency. For some reason, or is it me?
Yes. I'm administrating. I just want to say before I do the communion, that I just want to confirm what Excellency Carol said, what she saw about the caps. I just also saw a lot of people that hearts is so hurt, that it is in so much pain. But God, it was like there was an oil of anointing on your heart today. And there was a line that was drawn. The things that has shaken your faith, your marriage, your home, your business, there's a line being drawn today. And your faith has been restored. And it was, you know, when someone has to take an energy drink, it was like an energy drink that is enforced into our people today from the heavens, from the Father. Amen. Can we just bow our heads before we take, Father, we take partake of your body. Your word says in John 6, we need to eat of you and we will live. And this day, Lord, we take the symbol as a body and in remembrance of you, Lord. Your word says in 1 Corinthians 11, from verse 23 to verse 26, if we partake of this bread, we do it in remembrance of you. So this afternoon, Lord, we take this bread in remembrance of you, Father Jesus. Amen. Let's partake of the bread. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We speak healing over your people, Father. We're eating of you and you say we will love my God in Jesus' name. And the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, he said in the same manner he gave thanks. And after giving thanks, he served the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. And Lord, as we take this blood in remembrance of you, Lord, we drink of you.
Yes, Lord.
In remembrance of you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah,
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Oh, what a bunch. Hallelujah. Thank you so much, Your Excellency, Pastor Irene. Pastor, oh my goodness, Linda, thank you so much. And we had a very different session today. We thank God for every single one of us that is on the Zoom meeting. I want to tell you that when we come here, we come to a well-maintained and opened well of water. And you know, Jesus is the spring of water up into everlasting life. He is the eternal
Amen.
Spring. So I want to bless you all today. I want to thank you for making your appointment sure. We are not here to waste people's time. We have not come to just mess around, but we are serious and intentional about the assignment that God has given us. And I want to say next Saturday, we will be prayer camp starts on the 19th, which is next Friday. So next Saturday, we will be ready in our prayer camp from 5 to 7 in the morning, from 7 to 9 at night for 6 days, nonstop, It's going to be a glory feast, and I really am expectant as we are praying and fasting through this period of time, how the Lord has been showing us so many things and preparing our hearts and also changing so many things around us and within us. So, excellencies, for those that of you that are have not been well, I trust today that you received an impartation of life. For those whose doors have been closed before you, I trust that God has been before you to open the way and open those doors. And we want to thank our speakers today for their faithfulness, for their lives that speak volumes, and also for all of us that participate week by week. We love you. We're family. We belong together. Awesome to see everybody. You're welcome to put on your videos and your unmute yourselves, and let's go out with the victory blow of trumpets in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Glory. Let's remember to pray for one another during the week. And we will see you on Zoom, GBR 11th virtual camp on next Friday. Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Bye.
Goodbye.